In order to install ElementalX kernel on your Nexus 5, you must first download the actual flashable kernel zip file. So go to the official page on XDA and download the latest release of the kernel and copy it to your device. Alright, so after having done that, reboot your phone to the custom recovery you have installed. In this case, it does not matter whether you're using Clockwork Mod or TeamWin Recovery Project, the custom recovery, as both recoveries will do the job just fine. So yeah, navigate to the downloaded zip file and install it. Shortly after, you should see a welcoming page saying that you are about to install ElementalX on Nexus 5. Just tap on next and now you will have to accept the terms of use. Check the checkbox and tap on next once again. Again, tap on next to continue. And now you have an option to set the maximum frequency for each core separately. Unless you want to mess with the frequencies, leave it as it is and tap on next. You will now be presented with a list of frequencies you can set as the maximum CPU frequency. Just leave it as it is and tap on next to continue, because what's the point of underclocking such a powerful device? Now you will have an option to select the CPU optimization level. Select ElementalX, however, if you are experiencing stability issues, you should reinstall the kernel and set this option to stock instead. After that, you will have an option to undervolt your device. If you want to save some extra battery juice, select the 750 as minimum and move on. After that, you will have to select the GPU governor. Just leave it as it is and tap on next. You will now have the option to enable both the sweep to wake and double tap to wake features on your phone. It's up to you if you want to install them, however, be warned that these features will drain extra battery. Okay, you will now be able to set other settings too, but I would just leave them unchecked and move on. As the last option, you have to select the installation method. I highly recommend you use the stock RAM disk, as that way you will not run into any problems when coming from different kernels. Finally, install the kernel, reboot system, and enjoy your new kernel.